Dear students, today I am going to explain about assemblers. Assembler is the one of the system software which is used to convert assembly level language program into machine language. It is a translator. Now we'll see the basic assembler functions in this class. This is the outline of today's presentation. Assembler directives. Basic functions of simple SIC assembler, then what are the various types of assembler, and what is the object program format, and two pass assembler, how it is going to work, and what are the data structures used by the assembler. First we'll see assembler directives. In assembler, the function of assembler is converting assembly level language program into machine code, but some of the instructions will be there. It won't be converted into machine language, but that will give instruction to the assembler. That instructions are called as assembler directives. Otherwise, it is called as pseudo instructions. Actually, it is not translated into machine instructions. It provides information to the assembler. Example for assembler directives are start, end, reserve byte, reserve word, byte, word, and so on. For example, start is an assembler directive. It instructs the assembler to start the conversion process. End is the assembler directive. It instructs the assembler to end the process. Okay, so it gives the instruction to the assembler. Next we will see the basic functions of simple SIC assembler. It will main function is it will convert mnemonic operation codes to their machine language equivalents. Suppose for example we want to instruction STL, it will translate it to 14 is the equivalent machine language value of STL, and it will convert symbolic operands to their equivalent machine addresses. It for example in the book example they have taken, it will translate RETADER as a symbol to 1033. Then next function is it will convert the data constants to internal machine representation. Suppose for example we are given the immediate addressing mode LDA has 4095, and then that 4095 is a decimal data that should be converted into hexadecimal, then only it will be stored into a memory. So the 4095, if we'll convert into hexadecimal, we are going to get 3Fs. That our function or that also should be done by the assembler. Build the machine instructions in the proper format. Suppose for example we are having LDA has 4095. Means in default, by seeing this, we can understand it is a format 3 and immediate addressing mode. For LDA, opcode is 01. So 0100FFF, and then that complete machine language equivalent should be represented, and it will write the object program into the records, then that will be taken as a output file. Then next we'll see the types of assembler. In assembler we are having the three types: single pass assembler, say two pass assembler, and multi pass assembler. Single pass assembler, it scans the program only once and creates the equivalent binary program. When the symbols are used before their definition, at the time problem of forward reference occurs. Suppose we use the symbols before defining, it means we need a forward reference. So in order to solve that forward reference problem, we are going for a two pass assembler. Here there are two passes. During first pass, the symbols are defined and symbol table is constructed. And then during the second pass, it performs the actual translation. In practically, mostly the two pass assembler only it is used. The next type is multi-pass assembler. Here more than two passes required to translate the source program into object program. Next we'll see how that object program will be stored. before that one example, it shows the how what is that forward reference problem. So here we'll take STL RETADER. Now the symbol RETADER is used first, then it is defined over there. So the assembler while it is converting, it don't know the value of RETADER. So it is using this problem is called as a forward reference problem. For solving that problem, we are going for a two-pass assembler. In the two-pass assembler, what it is going to do means during the first pass, it will define the symbols. So during the first pass itself, it will define that RETADER as 1033. Then during second pass, the conversion process will be taken care. That time, that RETADER value will be there in the symbol table. There, the assembler will refer and it will take the value. So the forward reference problem will be solved by using a two-pass assembler. Next, we'll see the object program format. The object program will be loaded into memory for execution. There are three types of records: header record, text record, and end record. There will be only one header record and end record. There may be more than one text records. Depends on the program, the number of text records it is going to vary. Then first we'll see what will be there in the header record. In the header record, there will be a program name will be there along with the starting address and length of the program. And the text record, what will be there means starting address of the particular text record, length and object code. And then end record contains the address of the first instruction to be executed. So that will be there in the end record. Then next we'll see one by one. First is header record. The first column represent H. And 2 to 7 columns used to store the program name. 8 to 13 columns are used to represent the starting address of object program. 14 to 19 that represent the length of the object program in bytes. That is the overall length of the object program. Then text record. It starts with T. First column is T. Column number 2 to 7 represent the starting address of the object code in record. 8 to 9 represent the length of the object code in the particular text record. And then 10 to 69 is used to store the object code in hexadecimal format. Then end record. The first column represents E. That indicates end record. And 2 to 7 column represent the address of the first instruction to be executed. Then I will see the representation. So for here, how the header record, text record and end record is used is H, copy. H indicates header record. Copy is the name of the program. And then length of the starting address is 001000. And length of the program is 00107A. If the starting address is not given in the program, we should take it as a 0. And here it needs the 3 4 text records are used. Then first text record, then starting address of the text record, length of the text record, and then object codes will be used, stored. And then finally we are having an end record. Then along with that, there is the address which specifies the address of the first instruction to be executed. So in this class we have seen what is assembler directive, what are the basic functions of assembler, what are the different types of assemblers, and we have seen what is the format of object program, that is header record, text record and end record. Thank you.